Gulet Mohammed, back on U.S. soil at last.
It feels great to be home. Wonderful. I feel great. God bless America.
Mohammed, a 19-year-old Muslim, was born in Somalia, came to the U.S. when he was three, and is now a U.S. citizen. In 2009, he traveled legally to Yemen, then Somalia, and finally Kuwait. He was, he says, studying Arabic. But last month, when he tried to renew his visa in Kuwait, he was detained by local authorities. In a lawsuit, Mohammed claims Kuwaiti interrogators whipped him with sticks and threatened to run electricity through his genitals, and that FBI agents threatened him and refused his request for legal counsel. Mohammed's supporters say he was held and questioned at the request of the U.S. government.
This is a test for this administration. The Obama administration promised to end the practice of proxy detention.
The State Department denies that's what happened to Mohammed.
He was not detained at the behest of the United States government.
When the Kuwaitis tried to deport Mohammed initially, they couldn't. U.S. officials confirm he was one of fewer than 500 Americans on the no-fly list, designed to keep people the government believes are a threat to aviation off airplanes. Mohammed had traveled to Yemen, headquarters for al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula, and Anwar al-Awlaki, the U.S.-born cleric. He had also visited Somalia, home of another terrorist group, al-Shabaab. Two government officials say his travel is not the only reason Mohammed is on the no-fly list. They will not give specifics. After his lawsuit was filed, Mohammed was given a waiver to fly back to the U.S., but when he touched down at Dulles Airport outside Washington Friday morning, his lawyer had to wait to talk to him because, he says, Mohammed was again being interviewed by the FBI. Mohammed has not been charged with any crimes, and he insists he is harmless.
Are you a terrorist?
Oh, I'm not a terrorist. What type of question is that?
Mohammed's supporters and lawyers say the government is engaging in baseless innuendo and has yet to produce any evidence against Mohammed. But the FBI and other government agencies are refusing to comment on the case because of privacy concerns, because of the pending lawsuit which accuses the U.S. government of violating Mohammed's constitutional rights, and possibly because there is an ongoing investigation. Jean Meserve, CNN, Washington.